Tô aqui com Amy Lee do Evanescence no hotel, um dia antes do show, para trocar uma ideia com ela, falar sobre esse festival Rock in Rio que ela tá tocando. Não é a primeira vez, ela já tocou em Lisboa, mas agora tá na edição oficial. Welcome back to Brazil. How are you?
Thank you. Very good. It's great to be back. It's been a while.
And you already played in Rock in Rio, but in Lisbon. Now you're here in Rio.
Yeah.
How does it feel for you to share this stage with so many cool artists?
It's amazing, especially after, you know, being gone for a few years. I'm honored. I was just watching on TV actually last night, which was Lenny Kravitz. Before that, I think was Shakira and everything else. I'm like, wow, I am still like sharing the stage with these people. It's really amazing. It's huge, and 100,000 people is a lot. So. Trying not to be nervous.
So, since the release of your last album in 2006, you've been away experimenting other kinds of art, such as painting and also like other kinds of music. How are we going to see all these experiences in this new album?
Well, I think you can see a lot of growth. I mean, for me, it wasn't that there was some big plan or research going on or anything. I wanted to step away. I've been doing Evanescence since I was a young teenager, and I really wanted to just be normal person in the world. I live in New York. I got to go see a lot of concerts, you know, and I've always been a painter. I love to make visual art as well as music. So, yeah, I did learn how to play the harp in the time in between, so there's a little bit of harp on the new record, you hear that. But I think in general it's just a stronger record, you know, by someone with a little bit more life experience.
Are we going to see your paintings on an exposition maybe?
Maybe someday. I would love that, actually. I take a really long, kind of like with albums, I take a really long time on my paintings too, so I think it's going to be a little bit of time before I have enough for like a full show, but yeah, I do want to do that someday.
And also, did you experiment like singing in some other way, or you know, having friends around and jamming at home?
Yeah.
How was this time?
Good. I kind of grew up that way. My dad's a musician, you know, I grew up in a musical family, so sitting around and playing pianos and guitars and ukuleles and whatever is just kind of, it feels like home, you know, food and music and family togetherness and all that. I've got a really cool group of friends in New York, and a lot of them are musicians too, just on the indie level, and it is cool to listen to their music and get together and sort of play around together. It's good for you.
You said you were watching on TV. I don't know if you had the chance already to know the bands that are playing the same day as you are.
Yeah. Well, I obviously System of a Down and Guns N' Roses. I know there's some other bands. There's apparently a Brazilian.
Peachy.
Yeah, everyone's talking to me. I haven't seen it yet, but I want to check it out.
You know what? You girls look alike.
Really? Yeah. Okay, cool. I'll have to
physically.
Meet her. Yeah, somebody else said that too. Uh-huh. Cool. Well, I look forward to meeting her. Is the music cool?
Yes, very cool.
Oh, cool. All right. Look forward to hearing it.
But it's in Portuguese. But anyway, the energy you're going to get.
Awesome.
How do you deal with the responsibility of being a woman and being a band leader and being a person with a strong personality and a lot of pressure, I imagine? Do you go to therapy? What do you do to keep your mind balanced?
That's funny. Well, I would say on one hand, the music is like my therapy. It's the one place where I pour all my deepest things, like the hardest hard parts and the biggest loves too. I feel like the music is something that keeps me sane actually in the writing process, but also I've got an awesome husband, you know. It matters to compartmentalize a little bit and go, okay, that was that, and now I have an hour today, half an hour something, you know, and it's for me to just be Amy too.
Seems like Brazil is going to be on the map of Evanescence forever now. Is it true?
Our Brazilian fans are just some of the best in the entire world. They're amazing and wonderful and crazy and passionate, and we love them. I'm on Twitter, and I promise at least 70% of the tweets that I get are in Portuguese.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're wonderful, so it feels always a little bit like a second home here for us when we come.
How do you get in touch with the fans? Do you tweet back?
Yeah, totally. We tweet, and now that's become more than anything, but also we have a fan site, and we have a fan club, and we go there and talk to them a little bit, too. Share pictures, little video clips, whatever.
How do you choose, you know, your the way you're going to dress on the concert and your makeup? Do you have a person who helps?
I do. Beth does my hair and makeup, and I design a lot of my clothes for the stage.
You do?
Yeah. I just got a new batch of stuff for stage clothes, so I'll be wearing something new tomorrow. But I think that I want to fit the sound of the music a little bit. You know, I want it to make sense. Like in real life, you know, sometimes I dress like total dork, and I wouldn't do that on stage because, you know, music is dramatic, so you have to look the part of the play.
Amy, thank you very much.
Thank you. I really appreciate it.
Have a great concert.
Thank you. I'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.